Good evening and welcome to the Middle Creek Coaches Show. This is the Sports Block, live from Ruckus Pizza in Cary. I'm Ryan Magnuson, and I'm joined once again by Ryan Grover and head coach Mike Castellano. The Mustangs are coming off a 44-7 win at Green Hope this past Friday, bringing their record to 6-0 overall and 2-0 in the conference. Coach, this was a game, this was Green Hope's homecoming, and they had a big crowd. They were flying a drone around. It seemed like they were going to try and pull out all the stops for this one. Were you happy with your team's performance?
We were happy that we got the win. We'd have liked to maybe execute a little better on defense in the second quarter and offensively about three drives in the first half, but we were happy to get the W.
Yeah, let's go ahead and jump into the highlights.
Okay, the highlights. The first play here is the opening kickoff of the game. We're really smart when we call things and our kids execute, so that's when they say we're geniuses. But here, this is a great kick by Michael Rubino. Up top, Isaiah Herring is going to get the recovery. And pre-snap, you know, we kind of got the look we wanted, so we called in for the onside. And you can see, obviously, there's a big opening up top, and that's the way we started the game. You can see from the other angle, just the very end of the clip, but that wasn't the best camera angle. But it was a good play for us, a great way to start the game. The next play is actually going to be the first offensive play of the game after we recover the onside kick. Brant Grizzell is going to throw a great pass here to Rasheem Eaton. He makes a really good catch, gets tackled, I believe, on the two-yard line. You see a great post play. And then as you watch tight copy here, you can see our OL as well as Elijah Perry doing a great job of protection and Brant stepping up in the pocket. And obviously at the end, you can see Rasheem catch the ball there and do a great job getting the ball close to the goal line for us. The next play is Tavon Holland is playing safety. He's on the second person, on bottom of the screen here, closest to the left. We're in a coverage. We kind of roll everybody this direction. And you'll see here, you can see interception. And Matt Marino right there does a good job picking that guy off. And Sands gets a good block. And we end up gaining, I believe, 22 yards on the return there. And that's something we work on continually is how to return an interception. The next play here, this is going to be a guy who's actually defensive player of the game. Cameron Tanjon, we call him Tex because he's from Texas. We moved here this summer. And he does a great job. There's actually two plays made on this. He creates a fumble right there. And then actually the quarterback recovers it, starts to scramble out. And you can see Anthony Mitchell dive to get the sack after the fact. That was a great effort play by two guys. You might not have heard this before, but this is Elijah Perry with a touchdown run. He's had a bunch of those this year. And obviously great blocking everywhere across the field. But that's him breaking a long run. He had 150 yards again this game. And then right here, this is a Stewie Fine on the short run. The reason this is in there is we wanted to show our offensive line blocking. We've gone 2 weeks in a row where an offensive lineman has actually been player of the game. And a lot of times little guys don't get recognized, but when you see the tight copy of it right here, you can see the work these guys do and how they're flying around trying to execute blocks to give us a chance. It has great fits there. And you'll see Chris there, and actually our can't believe Chris has a big crowd. such a quiet guy. But Bobby was actually our player of the game, and he was on that play, and Chris just talked to him in a little while. But those offensive line guys kind of make it go for us, especially on offense. You can have all the great skill guys you want. And we have a great running back, with a couple great running backs, great quarterback, some really good wide receivers. But, you know, without that OL, you can't do anything. So I just wanted to highlight those guys for a minute.
Yeah, so was there anything that you felt these guys did in particular really well against Green Hope that you've been working on, you know, in practice or anything?
Well, you know, we work on a lot of things in practice. One couple of things we were excited about is finishing plays, trying to start quick. Here we started quick, obviously, an onside kick, big pass, and then a touchdown, the third play of the game. Defensively getting out there and getting off the field quickly. I believe we had four interceptions, and we were excited about that. We're trying to focus on getting turnovers.
Obviously, a great start to the season. What are some of the things, and kind of building off the question Ryan asked, what are some of the things that you guys, that you've seen so far, that you guys are doing consistently to help you get those W's?
We're playing hard, and that's one thing. We want to continue to play hard, bring a lot of effort when we do it. There's a lot of things we have room for improvement on. We could be here all night if I started listing them, but we're playing hard, and that's the one thing. If you can practice hard and carry that over to the game, you have a chance to be successful.
Mm-hmm. And that defense, you mentioned four or five turnovers that you guys caused. They just seem to be really, really opportunistic and really aggressive. So is that something that, you know, that you can really try and practice day in and day out, or is that more of an instinct thing for them?
It's a mentality, but most important, you have to trust your teammates, and they'll do their job if you do yours. And you know, it takes a lot of guys to create a play. It's never one guy who actually makes the play. You know, Tavon had a great interception with a great return, but really it started with some pressure up front from the DL. It started with the linebacker being in the right spot to force the high throw, and then it starts, you know, with two guys chasing the play to make sure they set up the return for them. So it's everybody doing their job, and you know, it's something we practice all the time.
And before we let you go to the next segment, you obviously have a little something that you want to speak about that's happening here at Ruckus tonight.
Yeah, this is our pink out game, and obviously Coach King's going to talk in a little while, and he'll tell you about the walk on Saturday. And we have a Middle Creek, I believe it's termed as a football team, but it's not just our team, it's parents, anybody else who wants to come out, that'll be on Saturday. But Miss Marcheski, a couple weeks ago, we had Sean with us, and Sean Horton from the middle school is battling his own struggles now and disease, but she created the bone marrow scan. So I actually went before I came up here and did mine out front. We're going to do it the game on Friday as well, but if anybody's interested in seeing if they're a possible donor match, all you have to do is go up front, fill out a sheet. It takes 30 seconds to swab each side of your mouth, and they'll let you know if you're a possible match, and then you can choose if you actually want to donate. You don't have to donate if you go out there and fill out the stuff and do it, but it'll tell you if you're a possible match to donate later on. A couple of our coaches are going to do it here in a little while. So anybody's interested in doing it, Ms. Marcheski is right out front, and it's a great cause, and we're excited that we're getting an opportunity to do that. So please take advantage of it, anybody who's interested.
Awesome, great cause. Guys, you are watching the Middle Creek Coaches Show, broadcasting live from Ruckus Pizza. This is a Sports Block. We'll be right back.
One block.
Oh!
And he just shrugs them off.
And he makes another two.
And kick is up. That's an absolute thrill into the back of the end zone.
You're watching the Sports Blog.
It is a ruckus. It's a good time. We've got live music four or five nights a week. And
you know, my favorite is the food, though.
Our menu is very varied. We have great hamburgers, great pizza, great pasta, great sandwiches, great salads. We're famous for our New York-style pizza. It's a huge 24-inch pizza with just right amount of cheese and sauce. And
all right, enough about the big pizza. Seriously. I sometimes still get a little bit long-winded, and this is a perfect fit for taking care of that.
It's great pizza.
Welcome back to the Middle Creek Coaches Show. This is the Sports Blog, live from Ruckus Pizza in Cary. And we are now joined by running backs coach Rayshawn King. Coach King. That's cool to say. Is it cool to hear that?
Yes, it's awesome to hear that. You know, just to hear the players call me Coach Kings, it's just an amazing feeling.
Yeah, so just tell us about your entire story at Middle Creek, you know, kind of briefly, and how you've got to this point, because I know it's a cool one.
So started out my sophomore year when I was a student at Middle Creek High School. I was diagnosed with leukemia, and going through that whole process was just – it was just a tragic process, but you know, I decided to feed my entire school, get my wish from Make-A-Wish to my entire high school, and went to college. And this end of this March, I was making a decision of what I wanted to do this summer. So I called up Coach C, you know, and we got in contact, and he's like, you know, we need some help. And I'm like, Coach C, I need some help because I need to find out what I want to do this summer. He's like, well, we're looking for a running back coach, Rashawn. And I was like, well, I would love to take the position, coach. So that's how I ended up at Middle Creek.
Yeah, that's awesome. So are you enjoying it so far?
Yes, I'm loving it. Just to be out there with the coaches and the players is just amazing.
Yeah.
Well, can you give us some of your feedback? Obviously, Perry's having a great year. Any of that you're doing, or you know, what can you add to that?
Like I always tell people, and like I was always told, you can never, you know, teach a player how to play with his heart. So Elijah Perry and the rest of those guys, Stewart and DeAndre, they're just great running backs, just amazing kids.
Mm-hmm. Good.
Yeah, it seems like, you know, Elijah is racking up the yards and the touchdowns game after game, and Stewart seems to get in there and put his head down and give you guys some good runs too. So what kind of things are you guys working on individually with those guys in practice?
Individually in practice, the first thing I had those guys do was stretch out, and then we just go in hard with each other, full contact. I made these guys flip tires, when the game starts, I just tell the guys to make sure they go out there and just play with their heart and just give it their all.
So you kind of want? Would you like to kind of go through what's going on this weekend as far as the walk and how that's going to go off?
Sure. So this Saturday, October the 11th at 5:00, downtown Rylie, North Carolina, at Halifax Mall, the Leukemia Lymphoma Society. Every year they have a walk called Light the Night Walk, and basically what we do with this walk is we walk for people that have passed away, who are currently battling and survivors of leukemia. Mm-hmm. And we just go out there and, you know, walk for those people. And also we raise money and for those people that are currently patients as well. And if you guys want to walk, just go to www.lightthenightwalk.org. You can go online and you can register under my team, Pray for Ray team, or you can register under Middle Creek High School football team. You guys will come out there this Saturday and walk with me and to support the Leukemia Lymphoma Society and their cause.
Obviously.
Awesome. So before you get out of here, what kind of things are these running backs going to see Friday night from this defensive front?
The running backs are going to see, of course, some great linebackers. And what I've been telling my guys through this whole entire, for this past week through practices, when we get out there, we gotta make sure we hold on to this ball tight, no more fumbling the ball. And just go out there and just run hard. And when you play with your heart, you know, your good results will show.
Well, we obviously appreciate your story, appreciate the announcement you made, and good luck on Friday.
All right, thank you, guys.
Yeah, thanks, Rachel.
Once again, guys, you are watching the Middle Creek Coaches Show, broadcasting live from Ruckus Pizza. This is the Sports Block. We'll be right back.
He won block. Oh! And he just shrugs them off.
And kick is up. That's an absolute thrill into the back of the end zone.
You're watching the Sports Blog.
It is a ruckus. It's a good time. We've got live music 4 or 5 nights a week. And
yeah, my favorite is the food, though. Our menu is very varied. We have great hamburgers, great pizza, great pasta, great sandwiches, great salads. We're famous for our New York-style pizza. It's a huge 24-inch pizza with just right amount of cheese and sauce. And
all right, enough about the big pizza. Seriously. I sometimes still get a little bit long-winded, and this is a perfect fit for taking care of that.
It's great pizza.
Welcome back to the Middle Creek Coaches Show. This is the Sports Block, live from Ruckus Pizza in Cary. And we are now joined by senior linebacker Matt Marino. Matt, thank you for joining us tonight, sir.
Yeah, thanks for having me.
Yeah, so you guys have a big, big crowd out here tonight. Do you want to start off with some shout
out? Hey, I'd like to give a shout out to my boy Chris Outten. We got Austin Lowick out here, Brennan Weinberg. Just want to thank y'all for coming out.
Yeah. So can you tell us a little bit about yourself, both in the classroom and then on the field, and what you do for this defense?
I'll definitely think my greatest quality would be working a hard worker. I think when I'm in school, I'm always trying to push for another letter grade. When I'm on the field, I'm definitely trying to push for another tackle, another interception, anything like that. As long as I'm always moving forward, I'm always trying to move forward.
Well, so you know, moving forward for next year, what are your hopes for next year?
It's been really stressful trying to pick a major. Mm-hmm. Because I want to pick something that I'm going to be happy with. Mm-hmm. For you know, the rest of my life. But I'm always an outdoors kind of person. Mm-hmm. So I definitely don't want to be sitting behind a desk or anything like that. I'm thinking something like sports medicine or something like that.
Awesome. awesome.
Yep. Yeah, so this this defense, we talked about it before, but the turnovers and the physicality, are those a couple things that you guys pride yourself in?
Yeah, I think those are all great, but I think that our team chemistry is probably the biggest part. We all, different from last year, we all bond together. Instead of messing around with each other, we're always focused and we're always pushing each other to work harder. So I think that's a great quality.
So what do you guys, you know, as a defense, as a linebacking core, what do you guys think you guys need to continue to work on a daily basis in practice?
I think we need to work on our tackling. We have a couple missed tackles between each game, so I think we need to focus on wrapping up and driving our feet. We tend to let the running back come to us and kind of take him down that way, but we all need to start working on driving our feet. And then we got passing. We got to work on our drops and stuff like that. We can't cross each other, and we all just got to work as a team. I think we're doing great now, but we got to keep it game by game.
Yeah.
So Middle Creek, Panther Creek is always a big game. What do you expect to see on the other side of the ball on Friday?
I expect to see a team that wants to beat us. And I used to be coached by the coach that coaches there, and he's a great guy. I know he's a good coach, and I know he's coaching really great down at Panther Creek. So it should be a good game.
So what do you think separates, you know, this year's team from maybe the ones previous before?
I would definitely say this team that we're going to play is definitely a lot. We all used to play with them in middle school, mm-hmm. So it's all we want to beat them. You know, mm-hmm. It's basically all of them against all of us. It's just middle school chemistry, basically.
Well, obviously, we want to wish you luck on Friday, and thank you for coming up here.
All right, thank you very much.
Once again, guys, you're watching the Middle Creek Coaches Show, broadcasting live from Ruckus Pizza. This is the Sports Block. We'll be right back.
It is a ruckus. It's a good time. We've got live music 4 or 5 nights a week. And,
you know, my favorite is the food, though. Our menu is very varied. We have great hamburgers, great pizza, great pasta, great sandwiches, great salads. We're famous for our New York-style pizza. It's a huge 24-inch pizza with just right amount of cheese and sauce. And
all right, enough about the big pizza. Seriously. I sometimes still get a little bit long-winded, and this is a perfect fit for taking care of that.
It's great pizza.
It is a ruckus. It's a good time. We've got live music 4 or 5 nights a week. And,
you know, my favorite is the food, though. Menu is very varied. We have great hamburgers, great pizza, great pasta, great sandwiches, great salads. We're famous for our New York style pizza. It's a huge 24-inch pizza with just right amount of cheese and sauce. And
all right, enough about the big pizza. Seriously, I sometimes still get a little bit long-winded, and this is a perfect fit for taking care of that.
It's great pizza.
Welcome back to the Middle Creek Coaches Show. This is the Sports Block, live from Ruckus Pizza in Cary, and we are now joined by senior offensive lineman Chris Outten. Chris, you also. Go ahead and get these shout-outs out here.
I would like to make a few shout-outs to all the players and all the people who came to see me tonight. Heck yeah. I like your support. And I would like to also thank all my family in New Jersey. They're probably watching this right now, so I'd like to thank them for coming and supporting me. And I also, my two biggest people that I would like to thank are my parents for, through my whole life, supporting me through everything, hardships, everything that I've done. They've been right beside me and pushed me into whatever I needed to do. Thank you.
Yeah, so tell us a little bit more about yourself, both on and off the field.
Well, on and off the field, first I'll go on the field. I can be serious at times. I can be joking at times. I would like to think that people think me as a role model. And I would also like to think that I'm a great player on the field. I give 110% effort when I'm on the field, and I give 110% effort when I'm off the field. I've learned in my life that to be the best, you have to do the best. And I also know that your best isn't always good enough. And that's taught me a lot in this football right now, that your best isn't always good enough, but never give up, because good things will happen to you.
Awesome. Do you just want to take over the rest of the show for us?
I mean, I can. Yeah. You can just give me the t-shirt.
Exactly.
Yeah. We'll pull up a chair right here. Yeah, co-host it.
So obviously your coach gave you a few nice words before when he was up here earlier.
Yeah.
What do you think this offensive line is doing? Obviously a lot of yards on the field that y'all are producing. What do you think you guys are doing as a unit to keep that machine going?
Well, first of all, I love all of our offensive linemen, whole patrol. That's what we call ourselves.
I like that.
And first of all, I think out of any player on the field, effort is 100% thing. Mm-hmm. And I feel that everybody in our offensive line gives effort every single play. Mm-hmm. And we compete with each other, and we yell at each other, and we want each other to do the best that we can do. Mm-hmm. And I think that's what the big issue is, that not a lot of people are giving effort. But effort's one of the most important things that you can do on the field. Mm-hmm. And also, I think we work really good as a unit. Mm-hmm. And competing's a big issue. Even as a team, we all compete. I mean, we're yelling at each other during practice. And I love that. I love when people are getting fights and drills and stuff like that. Because you know, like, they want that spot. And they want you to compete to get that spot.
Sure.
So, yep. I love my offensive linemen. And, yep.
Yeah, so are you on the interior of the offensive line, or are you on the outside?
I am not on the outside. I'm definitely on the interior.
Okay, so tell us a little bit about your role in that offense.
Well, I play center and guard right now. Mm-hmm. In center, it's a lot of being a leader, calling out the fronts, making sure everybody knows what they're doing. And an offensive guard, it's a lot more movement than center, because the center, you're blocking back a lot. But in offensive guard, there's more pulling, there's... as you saw in the play before, there's a lot more upfield blocks and stuff like that. So,
and so moving forward into this next Friday, what do you think this unit needs to work on, or what have you been working on to get ready for Panther Creek?
Well, a lot of things that we've been working on is, I think a few things that we had trouble with last game were double teaming. And that's a big issue in all of these games that we've played so far. Mm-hmm. And we need to get that guy out of the way and then move up and bump somebody off to get the linebacker or whoever we need to do. So we've been working on that during practice. And also we work on a lot of the screen game during practice, because we're a spread team and we run screens.
Yeah.
So getting out there, taking our sets, getting out there to being flat and making that good block and locking up with that person.
Awesome. Yeah, so what are your plans for post Middle Creek?
Well, my plans are either to go into ECU or State, study pre-med, and go to chiropractic school and become a chiropractor and go after my father. My father's actually a chiropractor.
Right on.
Well, obviously you brought a lot of energy, brought a lot of fans. We want to thank you for coming and good luck on Friday.
Thank you.
Once again, guys, you're watching the Middle Creek Coaches Show, broadcasting live from Ruckus Pizza. This is the Sports Block. We'll be right back.
Ruckus, it's a good time. We've got live music 4 or 5 nights a week. And
you know, my favorite is the food, though. Our menu is very varied. We have great hamburgers, great pizza, great pasta, great sandwiches, great salads. We're famous for our New York style pizza. It's a huge 24-inch pizza with just right amount of cheese and sauce. And
all right, enough about the big pizza. Seriously. I sometimes still get a little bit long-winded, and this is a perfect fit for taking care of that.
It's great pizza.
You gotta turn it up about a 12 or a 13. Welcome back to the Middle Creek Coaches Show. This is the Sports Block, live from Ruckus Pizza in Cary. And we are now joined by head swimming coach Mazaliyah Morris. Coach, thank you for joining us tonight.
Thank you for having me.
Yeah, can you just start off by telling us a little bit about yourself and your coaching philosophy?
Well, I'm Mazaliyah Morris. Third year, also coaching at the YMCA in Durham. I'm a Yoda coach as well as a developmental coach. My philosophy is just to have good sportsmanship, allow kids to have fun, and create personal goals.
Awesome. So where are you guys at? You're not in season yet, correct? So
correct.
Where are you at right now?
So right now we're actually at the interest phase, seeing who's coming back on the team, getting the freshmen to sign up. We're getting physicals in, and we are in the process of delegating captains, all that pre-work that you do before the season begins.
Cool. Obviously, can you give us a few you know, swimmers that you know you can kind of count on going into this year, kind of your cornerstones of the team so far?
So two of them you'll see today. I have two of my cornerstones, people that I can count on that I know that I'll be at every meet. So Some other people to look for is Sarah Gamber. You also have a returning swimmer who is undecided right now due to an injury. But to be honest, the whole team. One thing about swimming is our swimmers are always on the AB honor roll, so there's no down for them. They're always going to perform high energy. We've always created goals for the swimmers, and every year they rise to the occasion, so this year won't be any different.
So what does the conference look like this year for swimming?
Confidence is up there really high. So last year we got higher than the goal than we were before. In states we were fourth, so we're just looking to maintain. We know that there's certain schools that we're not really able to compete against just because of how the swimming bracket is, but we're not looking to go down either, so we're going to be the same.
So what steps do you take to fill those spots and bring a well-rounded team to those meets?
Well, in swimming, you have two different worlds. You have the world of year-round, and then you have the world of those who swim for summer leagues. You bring those two together, and you do the best when it comes to stacking. You take your top times, and then you take those people who are going to break times. They're swimmers who they're going to perform at every meet and drop time at every meet, and you continue to take those swimmers who are going to drop their time. And you take the swimmers that are going to give you commitment. Everybody who's there, I take them and I swim them all.
sounds like a heavy schedule.
With swimming, last year we had about 47 swimmers. This year I estimate right around 50. So we come with it. There's teams out there that look like they have 75 people up there. So you have to compete with that.
And so for every meet, you don't bring everybody?
We bring everybody.
And like so is everyone competing at every single meet?
Everybody competes. A swimmer can do two individuals, and then we'll take our best and put them on a relay, and we'll have two individual freestyle relays, and we'll do two medley relays. And everybody who's ready to swim, you can swim up and down two laps. I'm not going to cut you, and we swim them all.
Well, Ryan is a really good swimmer. He has that.
False.
Are you coming out to support us this year?
False. I will support you.
He has that Nordic blood in him. He can swim.
That's news to me.
Well, obviously, we want to wish you luck on the upcoming season, and thank you for coming up here.
Thank you for having us.
Once again, guys, you are watching the Middle Creek Coaches Show, broadcasting live from Ruckus Pizza. This is the Sports Block. We'll be right back.
He won block.
Oh!
And he drugs them all.
And kick is up. That's an absolute thrill into the back of the end zone.
You're watching the Sports Blog.
It's a ruckus. It's a good time. We've got live music 4 or 5 nights a week. And
you know, my favorite is the food, though.
Our menu is very varied. We have great hamburgers, great pizza, great pasta, great sandwiches, great salads. We're famous for our New York-style pizza. It's a huge 24-inch pizza with just right amount of cheese and sauce. And
all right, enough about the big pizza. Seriously. I sometimes still get a little bit long-winded, and this is a perfect fit for taking care of that.
It's great pizza.
Welcome back to the Middle Creek Coaches Show. This is the Sports Block live from Ruckus Pizza in Cary. And we're now joined by senior swimmer Rylie Marcotte. Rylie, thank you for joining us tonight.
Thanks.
Yeah, if you could just start off by telling us a little bit about yourself in the classroom and in the swimming pool.
I'm studying athletic training and going to college for it. This is my fourth year swimming and captain.
Oh. Where are you going to college at?
Not sure yet.
Okay.
Well, obviously being a cornerstone of the swimming team, that comes with a lot of hard work and dedication. How do you think your coach put you in this position?
This is my 13th year swimming, so I've put a lot of hard work into it, and it's practice every day.
Swimmers are hard workers, man.
Yeah.
Yeah.
What kind of things have you worked on over the years to get to where you are right now?
Well, I've had to come over a couple of injuries, and so I've done a lot of morning workouts with the team, a lot of afternoon practices, and extra workouts with them.
Like we were talking about before, it's the off season right now. What are you doing as an athlete to get ready for the season?
We're doing a little bit of workout on our own, some running, some abs, some core workout, stuff like that to get us ready for the season.
And what kind of things benefit you the most in the pool when you're doing out of the pool workouts?
Definitely endurance. Mm-hmm. It's a helper when you're swimming.
Looking at the conference, what are some of the teams that you're kind of looking forward to being competitive against?
Definitely Green Hope and Panther Creek. Mm-hmm. Apex, we're head-to-head with. Mm-hmm. About the same number of swimmers and year-round swimmers.
Mm-hmm. Do you have a favorite memory from swimming so far?
Definitely my state record.
Oh. What was that? Yeah, what was that for?
The 200 freestyle relay.
Awesome.
So if you could swim anywhere in the world, in a pool or in an ocean, where would it be?
Definitely Beijing.
Why?
That's where the Olympics were.
Oh, okay. That's a good answer. Yeah.
It's quick and simple. Well, obviously, good luck in your training upcoming, and thank you for joining us.
Thank you.
Once again, guys, you're watching the Middle Creek Coaches Show, broadcasting live from Ruckus Pizza. This is the Sports Block. We'll be right back. Thank you.
Thank you.
One block.
Oh.
And he shrugs them all.
And he makes another two.
And kick is up. That's an absolute thrill into the back of the end zone.
You're watching the Sports Blog.
One block.
Oh.
And he shrugs them all.
And he makes another two.
And kick is up. That's an absolute thrill into the back of the end zone.
You're watching the Sports Blog.
Welcome back to the Middle Creek Coaches Show. This is the Sports Block, live from Ruckus Pizza in Cary. And we are now joined by junior swimmer Brett Dickey. Brett, thank you for joining us tonight, sir.
Thanks for having me.
Yeah, could you just start off by telling us a little bit about yourself, both in the classroom and in the swimming pool?
I'm a year-round swimmer, so I'm trying to do my best for Middle Creek, I guess. In the classroom, I just try my best whenever possible.
Yeah. So how long have you been swimming?
This will be my fourth year swimming.
Okay.
So as a year-round swimmer, what are some of your what are some of the things that you're kind of responsible? What are the difference between seasonal swimmers and year-round?
The difference between them is for year-round swimmers, you are required to attend a certain amount of practices regardless.
Mm-hmm.
And there are certain consequences if you don't.
So you're always swimming, always practicing.
Yep, it's quite difficult.
So you've got to love something to do it that much. So when did you realize that swimming was really something that you had a passion for?
A few years back, I wasn't really doing anything. I was kind of sitting around home, just wasting
my time.
I know
what that's like. Yeah.
And my mom just kind of pushed me to do it, and
cool.
Stuck.
Yeah.
She told you to pick a sport. I like that.
Yeah.
Go ahead.
Yeah, so, skipping ahead to, when you're going into conference, are there any teams that you look forward to beating? You got any friends in other high schools or anything like that?
I have a bunch of year-round swimmers, or year-round friends that go to Green Hope and Panther Creek, but I think we have a chance of competing with Apex and Nightdale this year.
Cool. And so what do you think you guys need to do as a team and individually to be a competitive team?
I think it would be best if we actually tried to be more of a family this year.
Mm-hmm.
In the past, it's been really fragmented with the school differences.
Mm-hmm. And
well,
so
our football players will tell you how important chemistry is. They did tonight, right?
Yeah. So if you could swim anywhere in the world, where would it be? And why?
Off
a cliff. That'd be pretty cool.
That would be cool.
Yeah, that would be.
More diving and swimming.
Personally, it would be a pool because
Maybe water.
Yeah. There aren't any waves in the pool. Calm. Relaxed.
It's where you find yourself.
Yeah.
Well, thank you once again for joining us, and good luck on the season.
Thanks.
Once again, guys, we're watching the Middle Creek Coaches Show broadcasting live from Ruckus Pizza. This is the Sports Block. We'll be right back.
Thanks, sir.
Thanks, sir.
It is a ruckus. It's a good time. We've got live music 4 or 5 nights a week. And,
you know, my favorite is the food, though. Menu is very varied. We have great hamburgers, great pizza, great pasta, great sandwiches, great salads. We're famous for our New York style pizza. It's a huge 24-inch pizza with just right amount of cheese and sauce. And
all right, enough about the big pizza. Seriously, I sometimes still get a little bit long-winded, and this is a perfect fit for taking care of that.
It's great pizza.
One block, and he shrugs them off, and he makes another two.
And kick is up. That's an absolute thrill into the back of the end zone.
You're watching the Sports Blog.
I'll get that from you after. Good evening and welcome to the Middle Creek Coaches Show. This is the Sports Block live from Ruckus Pizza in Cary, and we are now joined by JV/assistant lacrosse coach, women's lacrosse coach, Lauren Householder. Lauren, thank you for joining us tonight.
Thank you for having me.
Yeah, so we've got a few extra cameras added to the mix back here. So we've got a few of your players out here. You want to start off by telling us a little bit about the team and about your coaching philosophy?
Last year was my first year coaching the lacrosse team, so it was a lot of fun. It was the first year we've actually made it to playoffs, so that was a big deal for us. And right now we're just in preseason, we're doing workouts, we're doing CrossFit, and we're getting ready.
You're doing CrossFit, huh?
They are. Let's clarify. They are doing CrossFit. But yeah, they just started today. It was the first day. Mm.
It's a good workout.
So I'm told.
Go ahead.
Yeah, so what is this JV team, first of all, going to look like, since you're closest to them?
Yeah, our JV team is really just about building the program and getting them ready to be on varsity. We have a lot of freshmen coming out, so there might be some who've never played before, but that's totally cool. We'll get them ready.
Awesome, yeah.
So what are some of the things that you were speaking about, some of the workouts that you're doing? What are some of the things maybe on the field that you guys are focusing on to kind of build off of the success from last year?
Yeah, we have a couple really good scorers, but we need to help them out on defense.
Yeah.
So our games were really close last year. I mean, some of them weren't so close, but our close games were mostly due to us not beating the other team down the field. So we've been doing a lot of speed and agility, and we need some stick skills just to hone those skills. Mm-hmm. But we have a lot of potential for next season.
Yeah, so lacrosse is a sport that's really still growing in the area, and it's, you know, I feel like it maybe is different, you know, especially at the JV level. Do you have kids, students that come in that don't know as much about the game, and is it like, you know, is there a teaching process to go through with it too?
Yes. We actually had a fair amount of girls who never played, don't have sticks, never probably even seen the game. So we really just start off with the basics, like passing, catching, cradling, and then kind of dive into offense, defense, how to score.
And how quick is that turnover? Has there been a player that comes out day one not knowing how to play and has seen some significant minutes?
Yeah, last season, a JV player, Mallory Webb, she just, like, blew it out of the water. And she really picked it up really fast and never played before, and she just became awesome. And we did have a few JV players kind of graduate to varsity before the end of the season.
Awesome. Yep. So can you kind of preview the young lady that's going to come in after you up here for us?
Yeah, Jennifer Garcia. She's our awesome defender. She's a senior this year, so a big senior leader coming up. So she really holds our defense down because we need some work done on defense. So, yeah.
Obviously, thank you for joining us, and good luck with the workouts, CrossFit. Do some burpees for me. Yeah, and you have
lots
a good
of burpees.
Yes.
Thanks for having me.
Yeah. Once again, guys, you are watching the Middle Creek Coaches Show, broadcasting live from Ruckus Pizza. This is the Sports Block. We'll be right back.
It is a ruckus. It's a good time. We've got live music 4 or 5 nights a week. And
you know, my favorite is the food, though. Menu is very varied. We have great hamburgers, great pizza, great pasta, great sandwiches, great salads. We're famous for our New York style pizza. It's a huge 24-inch pizza with just right amount of cheese and sauce. And
all right, enough about the big pizza. Seriously, I sometimes still get a little bit long-winded, and this is a perfect fit for taking care of that.
It's great pizza.
One block.
Oh!
And he just shrugs them off. And he makes another turn.
And kick is up. That's an absolute drill into the back of the end zone.
You're watching the Sports Blog.
Welcome back to the Middle Creek Coaches Show. This is the Sports Block, live from Ruckus Pizza in Cary. And we are now joined by senior lacrosser Jennifer Garcia. Jennifer, thank you for joining us tonight.
Thank you for having me.
Yeah, do you want to kick it off with some shout-outs here?
I'd like to give a shout-out to all my friends on the lacrosse team, as well as my family watching this today, and everyone here at Ruckus tonight.
Yeah, so we just talked to one of your coaches here, and she gave you a little preview, but she said, we need help on defense this year, so what does that mean to you?
I just think that we need a little bit more speed on the team. I think we have pretty much a good amount of endurance, but I think it's just more conditioning to build up our speed. Yes.
Well, can you just talk about kind of your journey through this lacrosse team, and obviously you're a senior now.
Oh, yeah.
And where you came from and how you got to be where you are now.
So I started playing lacrosse my sophomore year. Mm-hmm. And I came in there completely not knowing how to play, but with the help of Coach P and Coach V, they really helped me build me up, and I did a lot of conditioning over the years with workouts and stuff, doing tournaments and all that. So eventually I got to build up to where I am today.
Mm-hmm. So what would you say to some freshmen that have never played before, never seen the sport, but are thinking about playing? What would your advice be?
I'd say just go out and try out for it, because we're always willing to teach people if they've never played before. It's a pretty easy sport to grasp, I think. So all you need is a lot of practice, and you'll get used to it.
And so it's off season. What are you doing? What are you doing individually and as a team to get ready? I know your coach kind of gave us a few things.
Yeah.
But what are you doing to get ready for
as
it?
A team, as you heard, we're doing CrossFit, which is very intense. We're doing workouts as well on Mondays and Wednesdays, and then a group of us, a bunch of girls, we're getting together to like do some shooting around, passing. And I remember over the summer, a lot of us got together to do insanity, to also condition. What else have we been doing? We just completed a 5K. So we're doing a lot of things. We're trying to come back bigger and better.
Well, it seems like you're doing a lot of things together as a team. How do you think that's going to help you moving forward into the season?
Oh, I think it'll help out a lot, because it'll build up our endurance, mm-hmm. and as well as our speed and agilities, and eventually our stick work. So cool. I think it's pretty good.
And it's fun too,
yeah,
right?
Yeah, it's exactly. Really fun. Yeah, it's fun, obviously, yeah. It's good to like spend time with our teammates.
Good.
Yeah, so what are your plans for post-Middle Creek?
Post-Middle Creek, my goal is to go to a 4-year college. I want a double major in business administration and philosophy of law.
Cool. Oh, snap.
Yeah.
What do you want to do with that?
Yeah, what do you want to do?
I want to become a corporate and immigration lawyer and open up my own firm.
What?
Nice.
So if you need help, you know.
Yeah, right, we here. Probably will.
I need a good immigration lawyer.
Yeah.
So any last comments about the season upcoming, some goals that you set, some goals that the team has set as a whole for the upcoming season?
I think one of our goals is to build a better bond between everyone. Like last season we had this thing called Big Sister, Little Sister, mm-hmm. where we had an upperclassman assigned with a lower classman, and just to make them feel welcome on the team, because I feel like once a team is better bonded together, they work well together, right, rather than not knowing who they are. So I think our main goal is to create a bond, and then as well as keeping the determination up. So just working hard, it's really our goal.
Awesome.
Yeah.
Well, thank you for joining us, and have fun doing insanity, yeah, 5Ks, all that good stuff.
Yeah, we're doing a lot.
Well, thank you once again. Alrighty. Once again, guys, you are watching Middle Creek. You're watching the Middle Creek Coaches Show, broadcasting live from Ruckus Pizza. This is the Sports Block. We'll be right back.
Ruckus, it's a good time. We've got live music 4 or 5 nights a week. And
you know, my favorite is the food, though. Our menu is very varied. We have great hamburgers, great pizza, great pasta, great sandwiches, great salads. We're famous for our New York style pizza. It's a huge 24-inch pizza with just right amount of cheese and sauce. And
all right, enough about the big pizza. Seriously. I sometimes still get a little bit long-winded, and this is a perfect fit for taking care of that.
It's great pizza.
He won block. Oh! And he just shrugs them off. And he makes another two.
And kick is up. That's an absolute thrill into the back of the end zone.
You're watching the Sports Blog.
Coach Mike Castellano. Coach, the team is heading into another home game this Friday against Panther Creek. They're 5-1 overall, 2-0 in the conference. They're coming off a 40-7 win over Cary, I believe. And they've got some talent. So what are you guys looking to do on your side of the ball on Friday?
First, we have to execute and do what we're supposed to do, obviously, and we're coached to do. Trust one another to actually accomplish our jobs. You know, they've got a lot of talent. Obviously, they're well coached. You know, they're in position now where they're, you said, 5-1, and their only loss was to Wake Forest. And obviously, Wake Forest is a heck of a football team. That was a game that was a pretty close game right until the end. So, you know, we just have to do our part. And before you go any further, I got to say, Chris Allen, I don't know what political position you're running for, but you were up here either lobbying or preaching. I'm not sure which one you were doing, but it was a heck of a job by him and everybody else, too.
Yeah.
Matt, obviously, a good job. But, no, you know, you heard our guys talk and a lot about it, and we like as coaches to hear what the guys say, because you wonder sometimes if they're listening to you. Mm-hmm. And it was funny because Coach Trump sat right next to me and said, wow, Matt verbatim quoted everything we're talking about. And and then you hear Chris talk about being close and being part of something. And, you know, that's what we try to bring to the table every week. We last year, it was funny. We were riding to the game, and I'm not Twitter or Instagram or any of that stuff, but somebody sent me a message, like 6 people, somebody I talked to in years, and had a picture of me sophomore year in high school. And I went, oof, that's some good hair. Good mullet. It was a really good mullet. So I had this pregame speech all prepared, and I kind of tore it up, and I said to the guys, you know, there's a short period in time in life when you'll be together and get a chance to play football with each other, and that's a special time. So, you know, make a memory. It's going to be a memory either way. Make it a good one or a bad one, and, you know, that's the kind of intensity we want to play with from week to week. But we understand it's something that could be taken from you. You know, win, lose, or draw, give your best effort. Hopefully execute the best you can.
I vote that we get that picture on the screen next week.
Too, it's deleted.
So cue it up.
We could probably find it.
It's deleted. Trust me, it's deleted. I said to Coach Trump, and he laughed all the way from Middle Creek High School, I think, to Green Hope High School after seeing that picture last week. So.
Okay, now I have to see it.
It's gone. Yeah, it's gone.
It's gone.
I promise you that.
Well, Coach, obviously we're getting into the meat of the conference schedule. The approach, obviously, there's things that you want to go out and do on a week-to-week basis. But obviously, this is a tough test this Friday. What things are you looking for in particular against this team to work on Friday?
Well, you know, offensively, we're going to take what they give us. We can't dictate necessarily how they line up or those type of things. And, you know, that's obviously our staff does a great job with that. you know, defensively, we got to be able to stop the run. That running back they have from Southern Durham is pretty good. He's a real good football player. And, you know, and at that point, hopefully make a team one-dimensional. Special teams-wise, you know, when we get opportunities to make plays, you know, we have to make them. You know, last year we were fortunate. We hit a field goal at the end of the game. We blocked a punt to set that up. You know, we had an onside kick that we recovered. So, you know, in a game like this, when a team's very talented, and it's a big game because it's the next game, but it's a big conference game for us. There's no lying about that.
Right.
No shying away from it. So you have to execute any time you get a chance, and when there's a play to be made, you have to make it.
And we're coming back home again on Friday, so going to be in front of the Creek Crazies and the home crowd. You know, do you have any message for the crowd?
No, you know, our fans are phenomenal, and it's great. You know, when we go places to hear and see our fans and the excitement. A lot of times I don't even notice till I watch the film and I'll see people's reactions. Like when I watched the onside kick the first time, I guess Saturday morning, and I see the onside kick and I see all of our fans and Creek Crazies and family members jumping up and down as we recovered it. I said, man, that's pretty neat to see. You know,
So
obviously you can see here with the turnout we have and all that, we have great fans. You know, Creek Crazies do a great job, and you know, it's just a lot of fun to play in front of them.
Well, Coach, good luck. Another tough conference game, and we'll see you on Friday. You have one more thing you want to?
Miss Marchese is still out there. Last time I checked, I think she had 8 people sign up so far. I know I saw Chris over here doing it after he got done speaking and a couple coaches. But, again, if you're interested in doing it, you can do it Friday. There'll probably be a lot more people there. So if you want to do it today and sign up for it, it'd be a great time to get knocked out right now.
Well, Coach, thanks again, and we'll see you next week.
Thank you.
Once again, guys, you were watching the Middle Creek Coaches Show, broadcasting live from Ruckus Pizza. This was the Sports Block. We'll see you next time.